So, welcome to episode 10.
Episode 10.
We're at 10 episodes already. I feel like we just started this...
Yesterday.
So we've been learning a lot about how to do this, so here we are. So thanks for all your support.
Right. And everybody I talk to is always like, you and your sister's show is so funny. And I'm like, good.
We're glad it's funny. Right. We think it's funny.
We think we are funny.
We're aware that our sense of humor is, you know.
Not everybody's
sense of humor.
Right. We just think we're hilarious.
Right. We do this for our entertainment, really.
Yeah, really, this is for something else.
It's for us. Right. A reason to get together every week.
Right. Do we need a reason? We don't even need a reason.
No, we don't. So it feels like a productive reason to get together.
It does.
I don't know how it's productive, but it is.
Right.
And we're not wearing the same shirt?
Yeah. Well, and she did text me, too. We were like, you're wearing your blue shirt?
Technically, that's my shirt.
Boo.
So I have a lot of new kid stuff, but I do not have two of the same shirt.
Right. I don't have enough new kid stuff. I have a bunch of tank tops, but now that it's getting, like, kind of cold and want to wear a tank top.
No, she needs new kid shirts, people.
I know. Send me new kid shirts.
Right. Not only is episode 10 super exciting, today the new kids announced their Cruise 11.
Cruise 11.
We've been waiting impatiently.
For a very long time.
Forever. So they finally announced it today and we're super excited and
it goes on sale
on Wednesday.
We're going.
And we're ready. We'll tell you all about it.
Oh, yeah.
It'll be amazing.
You're going to hate us.
It'll be all you'll hear about. So, right. We get to Fangirl on a cruise with the new hits on the block.
And we're going to happy clap
about it a lot.
Yeah.
And do the, like, right.
Do our dance moves. We're going to get ready because we need to get our dance moves.
Practice our dance moves, yeah. So that will be happening. We'll probably do, like, maybe we can sneak in a little bonus episode this week of the booking process on Wednesday.
Right.
If we're not too stressed out to deal with that.
Right. We're not pulling our hair out.
Very stressful.
Situation.
But we're going to do that. And we'll tell you all about it. So, if you didn't watch last week's video, you should go back and do that.
Right.
Because it's a tiny little bit about the history of fangirling. Obviously not the whole history because
we don't even know. Right.
Who has time for that?
Right.
But we'd learned a little bit and shared it with you, and then we talked about how this week we're going to share our defining fangirl moments, and we asked around to get some of yours, and we have a few of those to share. So, tell me about your defining fangirl moment. And for, I had a lot of people, when I asked people about what it was, they asked me, like, what do you mean?
Yeah.
Like, that moment that takes you from being a fan, you know, just a person, like,
I'm going to go to their concert occasionally. Yeah.
I'm going to go to the concert when they're in town and, like, go crazy and buy a t-shirt.
To buying all of the t-shirts.
Going to all the concerts and all the t-shirts and going on cruises and...
I know some artists do, like, resorts instead of cruises.
Oh, yes. And, like, the VIP options at concerts and, you know, like, doing this over cruise announcements.
Right.
So that moment that takes you from one to the other. For some of us, that was a defining moment, and for other people, we learned it was more of a process. So, right. So tell me about yours.
Mine is we went to the concert in Grand Rapids, the Nuka's on the Block with TLC and Nelly. Was that it?
Yes. Well, it was the... Main event tour,
yes. And we got floor seats. We were, like,
third row?
And so, like, we're there, and it's, you know, you get down there, and you, you know, normally you go, if you go, obviously, ever been to the Grand Rapids Arena, you go upstairs. You don't go upstairs. If you're on the floor, you go to, like, the sneaky side, and, like, you're in, and you're like, whoa, I feel fancy. And then you're, like, down there, and you're like, whoa, the stage is right there. And then they come out.
And the stairs were right there.
And you're like, holy my life. Like, what? They're right there. They're people. They're real people. They're right there. And I touched everybody's hand. And TLC's backup dancer liked my hair.
She did.
And it was the best day of my life.
Mine was similar, only a little bit earlier for their tour. I think that was just the package tour is what they called it, where they toured with Boys to Men and 98 Degrees. And
98 Degrees or Backstreet Boys?
No, 98 Degrees. Okay. And so we had gone to the show in Detroit. And then later I found out they were doing a show in Mount Pleasant that didn't include Boys to Men. It was just New Kids and 98 Degrees. And I went with my best friend Jenny, because she wasn't able to go to the Detroit show with us. I went with Jenny, and we got pretty decent seats considering how late in the game we were to finding out that that one was happening. I think it was added later as one was canceled, or I don't know the story, but it was not on the original, like, list of
concerts,
you know, venues, but then it was on the website. So anyway, so we went, and then they always come out in to the audience for the show tonight, and, like, we were right on the edge, and they came out and thing. Jenny went that way because Joey was that way, and I went this way because Donnie was this way, and he, like, walked by and grabbed both my hands, and then, like, my life paused. I had no idea what was happening, and I didn't know where I was. And I went back to Jenny, and I was like, and she was like, did you see how close Joey was? And I was like, Donnie grabbed my hands. And she's like, what? How did that happen? And I was like, I don't know. I don't know how it happened. So it happened. Like, was standing there, and he
why didn't you see it?
And, like, it was all I could think about. And that's, like, from that point on, I was like, well, now I would like to go on the cruise and to all the concert and all the places.
And everywhere. Be best friends with Donnie.
Right. I want him to be my best friend.
We just want to be best friends.
I know. So that was my moment that turned me from a casual concert goer to fangirls. So, I couldn't even, like, say words. I was just like.
Right. I remember turning around and being like, everybody saw that, right?
And, like, nobody else cares.
Nobody's a
girl having their own experience. Yeah. Like, nobody cares what happened
to you. Nobody cares what happened to you.
Because the girl next to me, like, got a whole, like, full body hug, and she turned around and she's like, his sweat is on my face. So I was like, he touched my hands. So we asked a few of our friends who are also big New Kids fans about it, and I call her my NKOTBFF because we became best friends, even though she lives very far away. So we went on the first cruise together, Jess. And she said her moment was when she went to a event that Joey did. He did kind of like a theater, like one-man show thing called, he called it The Kid. And I didn't go to it, so I couldn't even say. I think he talked a lot about his life as growing up from being a kid in the thing, so
I think it was kind of funny, and also there was singing, and
he's just kind of funny. So she said she went to see it, and then went and saw it again, and then went back a third time so that she could get her picture taken with him.
That sounds like Jess.
And I was like, wow, why did I get to go see that? So I think it was just a Denver thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I didn't even know that had happened until she told me about it afterwards. It happened before I knew her. And so I was like, oh, yeah, that would do it. Like, go see, because Joey's, she's a Joe girl. So she got to go see an event that was just Joe more than once, and then got her picture taken with him. So
that was her fangirl moment.
Mm-hmm. So what else, who did you ask?
Well, I just asked, like, Mom and Sharon, and they don't necessarily, like, have, like, a one band thing or like one person fangirling thing, but like Sharon and our Uncle Paul go to
all of the concerts, every single one,
that anything, they'll see anything. For her friend had gotten her backstage passes for an REO Speedwagon concert, and it was like she was younger, and so they met the Kevin Cronin.
I think it's pronounced Cronin.
And her friend Sue, who was like apparently a big fan, couldn't talk, and I guess that's unusual for her friend Sue. So Sharon had to be like, hi, we're here to see you. She's lost her mind.
They're probably used to that happening.
They're probably used to that happening.
I usually can't come up with anything more brilliant than,
hi.
Hi.
So, that, and then I had asked, mom, and our mom used to work at, a record store.
An old-fashioned record store.
Yeah, like, records.
Where you used to have to go to a store to buy music.
Right. Remember those days?
Right.
And, like, before cassette tapes, like, records. And, so she met some famous people, but she got to go on Cheap Trick's bus because they were, like, tour bus, because they were, like, recording at some place, and they, she, I don't know, she didn't tell me the whole story, but she got on the bus to Argos, or to Cheap Trick's, and then she also got backstage to Cheap Trick's concert, too, so.
So she was, like, in.
Yeah, she's like, a, what do they call them? Groupies back then.
Right.
So.
But not the girls. Game.
But not, yeah, not the girls.
Game. Not the girls. Game, yeah, the groupies. So I asked a few other of the girls that I know through the New Kids on the Block community that we've met at different events. And one of them said it was kind of like a gradual process. She, like, went to, her name's Abby, and she's from Chicago. Hi. She went to, like, a concert, and then she liked it, and then she went to another concert, because there's usually, like, two in Chicago.
Yeah.
And then she was like, well, that's not good enough, and I'll go to any of the ones that are, like, a three-hour drive from Chicago. And so she went to all of those, and then her words were, and then I lost my mind.
Which, yes, you do.
Yeah.
You do.
That happens.
Mm-hmm. So fast.
And then another girl I know named Kelly, who I also met through the Cruise New Kids community, she said hers started,
hi Kelly,
way back in 1989, where she went to a concert and then, like, got to do things like hang outside of hotels and venues to, like, meet them, which in 1989, I didn't even know that that was a thing. Like, yeah. I didn't even know when the concerts were. And let alone would I know that that was a thing you could do, was go, like, I mean, we stalk tour buses now, but she got to go do that. So that's awesome.
Right. Well, of course, in, like, 1989, I was 5, so I probably wouldn't be doing that.
I was 11, so I probably wouldn't have done that either, because I wouldn't need, like, my mom to drive me.
Mom, can you drop me off at this weird hotel somewhere at 11? No.
No, it's not going to happen.
Right.
So if you still have stories out there that you'd like to share.
Right. What was your defining moment for your fangirling? Whatever it is, it doesn't have to be New Kids.
Yeah.
We want to know. Come on.
Yeah. I mean, like, not everybody loves the New Kids. We know
Which
that.
Is fine.
That's fine. We know that. Because everybody has their you know, whatever it is.
Brad's thing is golf.
Yeah. He fangirls for golf.
He does.
So stay tuned, and we'll keep you up to date on cruise news. So if you've been on a cruise of a band or thing that you are a fan of, or gone to one of those types of events, we want to hear about your fun experiences. That'd be fantastic. So send those in, and we'll see you next week for episode 11.
11.
We like the boys. The boys in the band. The boys in the band. The boys in the band.